Good afternoon, children. In the last class, we dealt about what is democracy and why democracy. Today, we are going to take up political science second lesson, that is constitutional design. So, why does a country need a constitution? What exactly constitution means? Okay. What is the process which was involved in making of this Indian constitution? The path to the constitution. These are some of the several aspects which we will be dealing in this lesson. Let us look into the overview. In the last chapter, we learned that in democracy, the rulers are not free to do whatever they like. There are certain basic rules that the citizens and the government need to follow. Okay, all such rules together, they constitute the constitution. How the government should function. Okay, what are all the rights which are provided in the constitution? What are the fundamental rights and what are the fundamental duties as a citizen we need to comply with? As the supreme law of the country, the constitution, it determines the rights of the citizens, the powers of the government and how the government should function. So in this chapter, we are going to ask some basic questions about the constitutional design of a democracy. Why exactly do we need a constitution? Okay, then how are the constitutions drawn up? Who designs them? And what is the process involved? And what are the values that shape the constitution in a democratic state? Once a constitution is accepted, is there any possibility for us to bring about changes? Because we see a lot of changes keep taking place. Our constitution, 70 years back it was constituted, isn't it so? So, as and when changes occur, what is the process for us to bring about these changes? These are some of the aspects which we will be dealing one by one. So, for us constitution, we are going to look particularly into constitutional design of India. Now, the constitution of country, let us look into the meaning. The meaning is, it is a set of written rules that are accepted by all the people living together in a country. So what it says, these rules are written down. Some constitutions are unwritten, but it is better for a democratic country to have written rule. That has been the practice when this French Revolution happened. Okay, and when United States also drafted a constitution for its country, it has become a practice for every democratic country to write down the constitution so that it acts as a framework within which the government and the people, we the people, can follow what is written in the constitution. So, what does it say? It is a set of written rules that are accepted. We people have accepted that we will abide by the constitution. And who are living together in a country? We have diverse set of people living in most of the countries, isn't it, so children? Now, every country has diverse groups of people. The relation, all over the world, people have differences of opinions and interests, whether democratic or not. Most countries in the world, they need to have these basic rules. This applies not only to governments, but it may be any association. They may also need to have a constitution. It could be a club in any area, or it could be a cooperative society, or it could be a political party. Some basic framework based on which if that particular organization will function. For example, if you take the example of school itself, we have a school diary. This school diary is useful for whom? It will be useful for the parents, it will be useful for you students, for the teachers. You know, we have certain guidelines, basic working of a school. You know, we have how many houses in our school. I know, what is the discipline we need to maintain? Is there any penalty imposed if we don't go by the discipline? You know, if a teacher has to communicate to the parent, she uses his diary. Okay, so there are several ways in which, you know, what exactly, what are our school prayers? So many things are mentioned in the school diary. Like that is for the working of our school, isn't it so? Now, when we take about the country, so how exactly the government should run? Okay, what are its functions? What are its relations? These are certain aspects which will be seen. Okay, the constitution is the supreme law that determines the relationship between people, that determines the relationship among people living in a territory and also the relationship between the people and the government. See, I've been discussing in the last lesson, in the previous lesson, like we have representative democracy. We people elect our representatives who work on behalf of us. So what type of relation do we have? Okay, these are the aspects which we'll be dealing with. A constitution does many things. First one is it generates a degree of trust and coordination that is necessary for different kinds of people to live together. See, we say, you know, we have people belonging to different faiths, so different religions, isn't it, so children? We speak different languages. So when there is a lot of diversity within us, so how are we going to live together in harmony? Then second, it specifies how the government will be constituted, who will have the power to take which decisions. Third, it lays down the limits on the powers of the government and it tells us what the rights of the citizens are. Now the government cannot rule the way it likes. Okay, people question the way of functioning of the government. So these things are specified. Fourth, it expresses the hopes of the people. So how we want our country to be. See, we have been under British rule for 200 years. So India became independent. Now we all know that we are living in independent India. So we know how got independence, but that time when we got independence we had many problems. Like that time only we had partition, there were communal rights, many people lost their lives. So how did we deal with all these problems? Okay, see, constitution is not something which was made overnight. It started in 1928, isn't it? So it has taken many years for us to compile this and make it into a good framework so that it will be useful for all of us. Now all countries that have constitutions are not necessarily democratic, but all countries that are democratic, they will have constitution. After the war of independence against Great Britain, and the Americans gave themselves a constitution. And after the revolution, the French also, these people approved a democratic constitution. Since then, it has become a practice for the democratic countries to have a written constitution so that the government can function within the purview of the constitution. Now, India's constitution was also drawn up under very difficult circumstances. So the first aspect what we saw was, what is the meaning of constitution? Let us try to recapitulate, children. It is a set of written rules, okay, that are accepted by all the people living together in a country. So we have accepted that these are all the things which we are going to follow. We will abide by the constitution. Then why we need a constitution? Because we have lots of diversity. We need to accommodate this diversity. We need certain framework within which we can work. The government can work. What is the relation between the people and the government? Okay, these are all the things which are specified in the constitution. Next, we look into the making of the Indian constitution. What is the process involved and what were the difficulties faced while framing this constitution? Now, when the constitution was made, the making of the constitution for a huge and diverse country like India, it was not an easy affair or not an easy task. At that time, the people of India, they were emerging from the state of subjects to that of citizens. We were under the British rule for 200 years. Now, we were treated as second-class citizens, isn't it, so children? We didn't have any basic rights. Only when our constitution was framed, we got our, our rights, isn't it, so children, as citizens of the country. So we emphasized, you know, our constitution makers emphasized on equal voting rights. These were denied before independence. Okay, so this was one task. Now, the country was gone through a partition on the basis of religious differences. We know how so many books have been written on partition and movies have been made on partition. There was a lot of bloodshed. Many people on both the sides, in Pakistan as well as in India, they have lost life. See, Hindus from Pakistan, they had to leave everything from there and come and settle in India. Indian from India, Muslims had to leave their belongings and then they had to go and settle in Pakistan. So it was a very traumatic experience for people in the both the sides. So our constitution makers understood that, you know, they shouldn't have these people fighting on the basis of religion. We didn't want communal rights to happen. Okay, we want people to live peacefully. Now, about at least 10 lakh people were killed on both sides of the border in the partition-related violence. There was another problem. The British had left it to the rulers of the princely states to decide whether they wanted to merge with India or with Pakistan or remain independent. We had approximately 500 plus, around 565 princely states. Now these states were independent kingdoms, they were not directly ruled by the British India. So now what happened, they gave the decision to the, so there was this task of merging these princely states. You know, it was not an easy task. It was Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel who, through this States Reorganization Act, he merged these princely states into the states which are existing now. Now this problem was also there. Now the merger of these princely states was a very difficult and uncertain task. When the constitution was being written, See, the future of the country did not look as secure at it as it does today. Lot of thinking went behind making this constitution, because that is the supreme law which everybody has to follow. So it was not anything which happened overnight. People had to sit and deliberate on so many issues, taking so many people into from different fields, from different walks of life to come into consideration, so that a proper document can be framed which everybody can follow. The makers of the constitution, they had anxieties of the present and the future of the country. They knew what India was undergoing when India got its independence. So they wanted a good future for its citizens. So you had to sit, deliberate, think, and then you will have to note down. Now, how was the path to constitution? This is regarding making of Indian constitution. It deals with the process involved, the difficulties faced. Okay, now next is, despite all these difficulties, there was one big advantage for the makers of Indian constitution. What was that advantage? Let us see. They did not have to create a consensus about what a democratic India should look like. Much of this consensus, it evolved during the freedom struggle. It is not that, you know, you had to sit immediately after India got its independence that you have to sit and write the constitution. So they had a fair idea as to what are the democratic ideals which India should have, what are the basic values which our constitution should have. So this, when did it start? Let us see. Our national movement was not merely a struggle against the foreign rule. Though our common enemy was British, we had in our mind it was a struggle to rejuvenate our country, and we had to think about the past. You know, we reinterpreted our past. You will be reading in your 10th regard, Nationals in India, how India's history was glorified. We had a very good past. Only thing, it was in cold storage. Then this past had to be highlighted. So there were sharp differences of opinion within the freedom struggle about the path India should take after independence. Though these differences exist even today, it's some basic ideas. The makers of the constitution, they had certain basic ideas which are going to be implemented. What are they? Let us see. As far back as in 1928, Motilal Nehru and 8 other Congress leaders, what did they do? They drafted a constitution for India. So a rough sketch was prepared during that time. Then again in 1931, the resolution at the Karachi session of the Indian National Congress, it dealt on how independent India's constitution should look like. So we had a fair idea as to how, when India got its independence, its constitution is going to be. Now both these documents, they were committed to the inclusion of universal adult franchise. See, if you see in French Revolution also, what happened? The women did not get voting rights immediately, and men with property only, they had this voting rights. Not all the citizens got equal voting rights. So we didn't want that. Even developed nations did not give equal voting rights to everybody. So these people understood the importance of voting rights, why it's important for the people to choose the representatives. So that is the fundamental principle of democracy, is based on equal rights, isn't it, so children? Political rights, equal political rights. So what happened was, you know, both these documents were committed to the inclusion of universal adult franchise, right to freedom and equality, and to protect the rights of the minorities. We have many minority communities in India. So how are we going to protect those? They should also feel secure. Majority and minority, both the communities should live together. We didn't want any differences to occur. So these are some of the basic values. They were accepted by the leaders and much before the Constituent Assembly met. Before the final draft of the constitution was made by the Constituent Assembly, we had certain basic ideas and values which should go into the making of the constitution. The familiarity with the political institutions. Already we were familiar with the working of this institution under the British rule. Okay, this helped us to develop an agreement over the institutional design. So how is it our constitution going to be? What is it going to include? What are the values which should be there? So a fair idea already developed. Now, the British rule had given voting rights only to a few. On that basis, the British had introduced weak legislatures. We didn't want weak legislatures. We wanted strong legislatures so that good laws could be made. Okay, the citizens' interest is of prime importance in any country. Elections were held in 1937 to provincial legislatures and ministries all over British India. They were not only fully democratic, but the experience gained by these Indians in the working of these legislative institutions, it proved to be very useful for the country in setting up its own institution. What experience they gained before India got its independence, that helped us in making a better constitution for India. Okay, that is why the Indian constitution, it adopted many institutional details and procedures from colonial laws like the Government of India Act. What are the sources from which India has? See, India's constitution is the lengthiest constitution in the world. Why is it so lengthy? Because we read the constitution of the other countries. The persons who were involved in making the constitution, they went through the constitution of America, the constitution of British India, the Australian constitution, like that, you know, of different countries. They took what is good from that and used it for our country, depending upon our conditions over here. For example, you can see many of our leaders, they were inspired by the ideals. See, for example, the legacy of French Revolution was liberty and equality. See, in our preamble also we mentioned social justice, equality, liberty, fraternity. We use these words. Okay, now many of our leaders, they were inspired by the ideals of French Revolution, the practice of parliamentary democracy. We have parliamentary form of government in India. Okay, the Bills of Rights in US, the Soviet Revolution in Russia. We have a mixed economy. From where did we take? We introduced 5-year plans. That is, these 5-year plans have been adopted from the Soviet Union, from the Russia. Now these has inspired many Indians to think of shaping a system based on social and economic equality. We want the wealth to be distributed equally among the rich and the poor. Yet they were not simply imitating what others had done. At each step they were questioning whether this is suitable for our country, whether parliamentary democracy is suitable for our country, whether like that each aspect was dealt in depth. All these factors, they contributed in the making of the constitution. The drafting of the document is called, the drafting of the document called the constitution was done by an assembly of elected representatives. So we read about the party constitution. Who were the people who were involved in this constituent assembly? Okay, how were they elected? Let us see. See, this drafting of the constitution was done by an assembly of elected representatives. They were called the Constituent Assembly. Now, elections were held in this Constituent Assembly in the year June 1946. Its first meeting was held in December 1946. Soon after, what happened? The country was divided. When India got its independence, it was divided into India and Pakistan. So, Pakistan had a different Constituent Assembly and India had a Constituent Assembly. The Constituent Assembly that wrote the Indian Constitution had 299 members. The assembly adopted the constitution on 26 November 1949. Though it was adopted at that time, what happened? It came into effect from 26 January 1950. To mark this day, for us January 26 was very important, because in the 1929 Lahore session, you know, we asked for complete independence or Purna Swaraj. So to justify that, what we did to mark this day, we celebrate January 26 as Republic Day every year. Now, why should we accept the constitution made by this assembly more than 70 years ago? You may get it out. See, we have been speaking, ma'am, long back the document was made. Why is it we need to follow even now? Suppose such a question arises in your mind, what answer do we have? The constitution does not reflect the views of the members alone. It represents the views of the entire India, citizens of India. It expresses a broad consensus of its time, where the people of India have agreed. Our preamble itself starts, you know, what are the first lines in our preamble? We the people of India. Okay, many countries of the world, they had to rewrite their constitution afresh because the basic rules were not accepted to all major social groups or political parties. You will be reading in your 10th class, we have a lesson called power sharing, where Belgium amended its constitution 4 times. What was the need for bringing changes in the constitution? Because there was the problem of ethnicity. They want to accommodate the social differences. People were fighting on the basis of language. So they didn't want this problem to happen. So many countries, whenever changes occur, sometimes if there's a need to change the constitution, they have rewritten. But we, to maximum extent, we have not brought about that many changes. You know, no one actually follows it. See, the experience of our constitution is different. Over the last half a century, several groups have questioned some of the provisions of the constitution. But no large social group or political party has ever questioned the legitimacy of the constitution itself. This itself speaks that, yes, our constitution is good. Okay, our constitution is, this is an achievement for our country. Because so much of deliberation has gone, so much of thinking has gone beyond making this constitution. The second reason for accepting this is, you know, the Constituent Assembly represented the people of India from different walks of life. There was no universal adult franchise at that time. So the Constituent Assembly could not have been chosen directly by all the people of India. How it was done? It was elected mainly by the members of the existing provincial legislatures. Okay, this ensured a fair geographical share of members from all the regions of the country. It is not that very few directly they have made this. Through the process of election, these members were elected to the Constituent Assembly. The assembly was dominated by the Indian National Congress. Now, but the Congress itself included a variety of political groups and opinions. You can see there are so many people involved in making from different walks of life. Later on, we'll be discussing this. These are all the people. There are many more people from different walks of life, from sports, you know, somewhere educationists, like that. You know, people from different walks of life participated. They deliberated for a long period. Okay, the assembly had many members who did not agree with the Congress. In social terms too, the assembly represented members from different language groups, castes, classes, religions and occupations. Even if the Constituent Assembly was elected by universal adult franchise, its composition would not have been different. Finally, the manner in which the Constituent Assembly worked, it gives sanctity to the constitution. The Constituent Assembly, it worked in a systematic way, in an open, transparent way and consensual manner, whether everybody, whether all the members are agreeing on certain basic idea to be included or not. Then, you know, there used to be lots of debates. A drafting committee was chaired by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. He prepared the draft constitution for discussion. Several rounds of thorough discussion took place on the draft constitution. The members deliberated for 114 days spread over 3 years. See, right from independence, from when India got its independence in 1947 till 1949, but it came into effect from 1950. So, for almost 3 years, every document presented, every word spoken in the Constituent Assembly, they have been recorded and preserved. What exactly went behind including these basic, in writing these laws? Okay, now these are called Constituent Assembly debates. When printed, you know, when these discussions, all these discussions which are recorded, they came to around 12 bulky volumes. These debates, they provide the rationale behind every provision of the constitution. These are used to interpret the meaning of the constitution. In order to understand the constitution, we can look into what has been written into these provisions of the constitution. So today we will wind up our discussion over here, children. In the next class, we will be looking into the guiding values of the constitution. Let us do a recapitulation. What we have learned till now, we have learned about the meaning of constitution. What is the meaning of constitution? It is a set of written laws that are accepted by all the people living together in a country. And what is the need for the constitution? How the Indian constitution was made? What was the process involved? What were the difficulties faced? And the path to the constitution and the Constituent Assembly. Till here we have discussed, children. The next module will be discussing about the guiding values of the Indian constitution. Thank you, children.